What's good? It's Woog. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's talk boxing. A quick thought on the heavyweight unification title bout between Anthony Joshua and Joseph Parker. I feel like Parker is about as big a threat to Joshua as I thought Luis Ortiz was to Deontay Wilder, which is one hell of a threat, but for different reasons. Whereas in Wilder vs. Ortiz, I thought that Ortiz being the better pure boxer than Wilder, an excellent inside fighter and a southpaw, would present new challenges. I think that Parker's size and athleticism, he is 6'4", only a couple inches shorter than Joshua, matched with his hand speed and his foot speed, will present new challenges for Joshua. Joshua's used to being the bigger, stronger fighter and the better athlete than a lot of his opponents thus far, with the exception of Vladimir Klitschko, who was 41 years old when him and Joshua had their classic battle about a year ago. Joshua's also used to towering over his opponents, where he can often control the spacing and dictate the terms of the exchanges. He can move, jab, move, then find his openings to let his power shots go without feeling too much pressure and without his space being invaded. Not that Parker is necessarily a pressure fighter, but he is likely to have the faster hands, which usually causes the other guy to be a little more reluctant with their punches. They can get apprehensive and their punch output decreases if they fear that the return fire, the counter punches, are coming in faster than their lead punches. Joshua is also usually the busier fighter, but Parker's hand speed and foot speed can potentially reduce that output. Now Joshua, like Deontay Wilder, has the great equalizer, and that's his out-of-this-world punching power. Parker also has knockout power. He's not as hard a puncher as Joshua, but he certainly does damage. Just look at some of his prior knockouts. Most fans, fighters, and experts think that Joshua wins this by knockout, and I've heard some people online, Richard Dwyer from Dwyer Boxing and Gambler's Advisory, check them out, going with the underdog Parker to win the fight, but hedging his bet with the Joshua KO because of the way that oddsmakers have priced the fight. Me? I actually think that this will be a very competitive fight, but I think that Joshua will be handed some of those close rounds that could just as easily go to Parker because Joshua is the money fighter in this case. The fight is in his hometown of Great Britain, and in those competitive rounds where they're landing nearly the same amount, or in the slower, less active rounds where there's not too much going on, jabs here, jabs there, not a lot of power punches landing, I find it hard that the judges will give those rounds to the underdog and lesser name in the game, Joseph Parker. So I see Joshua winning in a competitive fight via decision, which would be his first time going the distance, and Parker would be the first opponent that Joshua didn't knock out. Some will probably even disagree with the decision and say that Parker fought an even fight and perhaps should have won the decision, but those are the breaks in boxing and the show goes on. The mega fight down the line between Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder has to happen, and although Joseph Parker is also a champion and one of the few heavyweights who has a legitimate claim at the throne, he's got a tough task. One, because of the actual opponent in front of him, Anthony Joshua, and two, to win a decision, Parker will have to win rounds convincingly enough to sway the judges to score those rounds for him. And his nonchalant, calm, almost lackadaisical style in the ring doesn't lend itself to those types of crowd-pleasing and judge-pleasing theatrics. Whereas Anthony Joshua is built like He-Man and just looks and acts like he's winning, even when he's struggling, I don't know if Joseph Parker is a good enough salesman to get that type of love from the judges. He definitely has the talent and is a live underdog, but I have Joshua earning a close decision in this one. So let me know your thoughts. Personally, I can't wait. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Woog. Thanks for tuning in.